Hello friends. On your great demand, today I'm going to discuss about the wave theory of light. The question whether light is a wave or a particle has a very interesting and long history. The great among the greatest scientists, Newton, believed that light is made up of particles. He performed a number of experiments to study the behavior of light. At the same time, contemporary of Newton, the Dutch physicist Christian Huygens suggested that the light may be a wave phenomena. Huygens' proposal was remained in doubt for almost about a century because scientific community by and large had great faith on Newton's writing and the particle theory remained in chair for a long time. Later, it was Thomas Young who seriously challenged the Newton's corpuscles theory with the help of Young's double slit experiment. In the previous classes, we must have got an idea about the motion. Wave motion is a kind of disturbance which travels through a medium and develops by the vibration of particle in the simple harmonic motion and transmitted from one place to another by the transfer of energy from one particle to another. Light is considered as electromagnetic wave. The wave developed through the mutual effect of electric force and magnetic force moving through a medium or the vacuum that is called electromagnetic wave. Now we will see what was the Huygens' postulate about the wave theory of light. Let us move to the classroom.
Hello, welcome to the class. The continuous locus of all the ether particle vibrating in the same phase is called a wavefront. In simple word, a wavefront is a locus of all those points whose phase are exactly the same. Let us consider a light source S and light is emitting from it in all the directions. And consider light wave traveling this way in all the directions. Light wave this way. Also, if in this direction, the light wave is this way. If in this direction, we'll consider this way. In this direction, light wave is considered like this. Also here, this way. So, a wavefront is a continuous locus of all those particles which are in the same phase. Suppose this particle, this point of a wavefront, of a wave. So this is having some phase. So similar way, suppose this wave has same phase and same phase. So look, the locus of all the point which have same phase or joining all these point which have same phase gives a sphere. The surface of this sphere is called a wavefront. So the continuous locus of all the ether particle vibrating in the same phase is called a wavefront. A luminous body is a source of disturbance in the hypothetical medium that is called ether. Okay. Now we'll discuss Huygens' principle on the basis of wave theory of light. I divided Huygens' principle in three parts. Huygens' principle. Huygens' principle. It says every point of a wavefront acts as a source of new disturbance called secondary wavelets. Every point of wavefront acts as a source of new disturbance called secondary wavelets. Okay, now second point, these spherical secondary wavelets moves in all the direction with the same velocity of light. And third part point states that the envelope of these wavelets wavelets at an instance gives the position of new wavefront at that instance. Okay? Huygens' principle states that every point of a wavefront acts as a source of a new disturbance called secondary wavelets. These spherical wavelets move or spread out in all directions with the speed of light, and the envelope of these wavelets at an instance gives the direction of new wavefront. What it says, suppose there is a source of light, because of it, suppose there is a wavefront, say AB. So what we say, what Huygens' principle says, every point of a wavefront acts as a source of new disturbance. Suppose a number of points, say A, B, C, D, E, these are the number of points. So, Huygens' principle says that every point of this wavefront acts as a new source of disturbance. So, what will happen? Light will emit from each source and it will be in a spherical shape in all directions. These spherical secondary wavelets move with the speed of light. So at an instance, if time is t and velocity is v, so with radius vt radius, a sphere is constructed and the envelope of this sphere, suppose this is the line or this is the surface which touches all the sphere, so the new position of suppose A dash and B dash, a new position of new wavefront is obtained at that instance after time t. And also a wavefront at backward direction A double dash down B double dash is obtained. So Huygens' principle is the every what it says, every point of a wavefront acts as a source of new disturbance. Okay, and these is and that is called secondary wavelets, and these spherical secondary wavelets spread out in all directions with the speed of light, and the envelope of these wavelets at an instance gives the position of a new wavefront. Okay, now I am omitting it. let AV be a section of a wavefront. Suppose S is the source, and let us consider AB is a cross section of a wavefront at an instance in the homogeneous heterotrophic medium. Okay, let the speed of light be v. Speed of light be v. To find out the position of wavefront after an interval time t, the following Huygens construction can be done. Okay. First of all, a number of points, say A, B, C, D, etc., are taken on the wavefront. Number of points, say A, say B, C, D, E, F, G, like that. H, like that. A number of points A, B, C, D, etc., are taken at an instance on the wavefront AB. All points are the origin of a wavelets. Okay. Several circle may be drawn with the radius vt. Since the speed of light or the velocity of light be v, and at an instance time t, so what we do, we take a radius of vt and a several circle is drawn like this way. One circle and another circle, another circle, a number of circle is drawn taking radius vt. The radius of this circle be, this is vt. Okay, at a tangent line AV is drawn which is common to all these circle in the forward direction. This way a common tangent line is drawn this way. Say this common tangent is A dash B dash. Okay, so a new, the position of after an instant time t, a new position of wavefront A dash B dash is obtained. It is the section of envelope. This is the section of envelope of secondary wavelets which gives the position of a new wavefront after time t. The direction in which the disturbance is propagated is called ray. The direction, this is the direction in which wave is propagated. So this is called a ray. This direction wave is propagating. So this is a ray. This is the direction in which the wave is propagating. Okay. The similar way we can take a plane wavefront. If we proceed further, so there will be a plane wavefront. A number of point A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, like that, may be taken on the wavefront A, B, AB wavefront. Okay, and a number of circle is drawn at this place. Point A is a center this way. A number of circle is drawn, and the envelope that is a line we can say take A dash B dash. A dash B dash. A dash B dash is the line tangent to all the sphere or the circle, we can say. Okay. So at an instance time t, so new wavefront is obtained A dash B dash. Okay. So Huygens construction gives the backward wavefront also shown by a dotted line. We can show backward line shown by a dotted line. So it is A double dash B double dash. Okay. So what was the Huygens principle? Huygens principle says we can explain Huygens principle in 3 points. First point says that every point of a wavefront acts as a source of new disturbance called secondary wavelets. Second point, these spherical wavelets spread out in all the direction with the speed of light. And third point says, the envelope of these wavelets at an instance gives the position of new wavefront. Okay? Now, on the basis of Huygens' principle, we can explain the law of reflection and the law of refraction. In the next class, we will discuss law of refraction and reflection on the basis of Huygens' principle. Okay? Thank you.